Hey guys, welcome back. So I have got a really fun video for y'all today. I've got a lip swatch party for y'all on these lipsticks right here. So these are the Wet n Wild Mega Last High Shine Lipsticks. So Wet n Wild so sweetly sent me this box. So thank you to them for sending these to me. So I'm gonna run through the different shades, show you swatches on my lips. I've already got one of them on right now and it's a very light color. So I'll show you swatches on my lips, also show you swatches on my hand, let you know my thoughts on these different colors and just do a fun lip swatch party. So let's get to it. So quickly, let me touch on the formula of these lipsticks. I think these are so good. They are creamy and comfortable and hydrating feeling on the lips. I think they look flattering on the lips. They look glossy and shiny. Just a beautiful formula. So I love the formula. They don't last super long on the lips, but it's more of that glossy formula, so you would kind of expect that. But they are just super duper comfortable and flattering looking on the lips. So I love the way that they feel. I love the way that they look. The packaging is beautiful. It's got a pretty little rose gold lip there. You can see the color through the top. Wet n Wild right there. So pretty nice packaging. Affordable. They are great lipsticks. Okay, let's start with the colors. So this one is Peach Please. And it is a light glossy peach shade. Very pretty. I would wear this with a lip liner or a deeper color around the outsides and put this more on the middle of my lips. I am noticing a little bit of it collecting on the middle part of my lips. Sometimes that can happen with these lighter colors. And I am noticing that, but I'm not noticing accentuating dry patches. So I think that is really good. Just a pretty light peach. Ooh, this one is beautiful. This is Close Off. And this is, I would say, more of a just a mid-tone nude, kind of a light brownie nude. This is like one that could just live in your purse. So comfortable and just easy. Easy everyday color. I love this so much. So yeah, just a beigey brownie nude. This one is Mad for Mauve. Mad for Mauve. And this one is a purpley mauve shade. Now I will say these are so creamy that if you press really hard on them when you're applying them, they can tend to move in the packaging. And I think one of mine that I originally purchased myself, I think actually broke at the base because I was a little bit rough on it when I was applying. So just know that about it. It's that super emollient formula. I don't think that's anything negative to the formula because I've had that happen with high-end lipsticks that are the same sort of emollient formula. So just FYI on that. It's a little bit of a delicate, emollient, glossy formula. So yeah, this one's a mauve-y, beautiful shade. I mean, look, it looks like a gloss. Gorgeous. This one is Rosé and Slay. This is totally one that I would keep in my purse forever because this is such a beautiful, neutral, rosy shade. You can see it's a lot less purple than Mad for Mauve. This one is more of a rosy pinky, but just sweet, girly. I love it. Oh my gosh. Beautiful. One of my favorites. This one is Pinky Ring, and this is a brighter kind of a pink, like more of a bubblegum pink. This one's pretty. I don't know that I'll get a ton of use out of this one just because I don't reach for these kind of colors, but I do think it's really pretty. I think it's well done and a fun shade. It's just, is this one that you would normally reach for? But hey, I mean, if you do want to try this kind of color, get it in a really affordable formula, you know, a really affordable price point lipstick with a good formula. How beautiful is this one? This is Strawberry Lingerie. And it is a pinky coral and a bright shade. It's pretty neon, but oh my goodness, for warmer months, this will be so fun. It is super glossy, as they all are. Flattering on the lips. It's a fun shade. This one is Bellini Overflow. Now, this one does seem to be clinging to some dry patches on my lips, but my lips are getting pretty dry because I've already swatched through all the matte ones in a different video, and then now I'm halfway through these. So I've been swatching a lot of lipsticks. So I would say if you get this one, before you wear it, definitely exfoliate your lips because it does seem to be clinging to the dry patches just a little bit. Not that bad, but I see it a little bit. So it's a bright peachy shade. Yeah, just if you like a bright peach. That's what this one is. And a pretty light peach. This one is Tangerine. the alarm. Tanja, ring the alarm. And this one is a bright orange shade. Do notice a little bit of clinging to the dry patches, but not that bad. For some reason, I find that with orangey shades, at least on me, those seem to cling the most. And I notice that across all brands. So I do see that a little bit with this one, but not all that obvious, just a tiny little bit. And it's if I'm really looking for it. But yeah, bright orange, pretty unique shade, very neon-y. Kind of a light tangerine shade.
Oh my goodness, I love this one so much. This is, what is this called? Firefighting.
And it's a glossy red and a soft glossy red. So if you are interested in trying red lipsticks, but you're afraid of them, you've never really worn them, this would be a perfect first step into a red lip because it is just glossy and soft. And you're not gonna have to worry about it as much, especially if you apply it lightly. It's almost like a little bit of a glossy stain on your lips. So pretty, just a little hint of color. Really comfortable, flattering on the lips. Just a classic glossy red.
This one is Crimson Crime. And again, it's a beautiful glossy red, but this one's a little bit more on the berry side. So if you like more of a berry red, then go with this one. If you like more of a classic red, a little bit more orangey, you can go with that one. Both beautiful. Love them both. Both are really flattering on the lips. Ooh, I love these so much. That one's so good. I don't know which one I would wear more. They're both awesome.
Absolutely love this one. This is Raining Rubies. And yes, it is a ruby berry sort of color. Flattering on the lips. Kind of more of that purpley berry, but not too purple. Again, if you want to try these kind of colors, I mean, I applied, you know, several layers of it, but you can apply it really lightly and you're gonna get a lot of that glossy shine and just a little bit of color, and then you can build it up if you want to. Awesome.
This one is Jam With Me.
And I would describe this one as an oxblood, but because it's so glossy, it's a lot less obviously intense, less scary. So yeah, oxblood, love this one. It looks flattering on the lips. It is not clinging to dry patches. Now, I would probably wear this with a lip liner, or I would just apply it really lightly. So one or the other, apply it really lightly where, you know, I'm not as concerned about a really even line or worried about it bleeding or anything like that. But if I applied a lot of it, I would wear it with a lip liner. So that's just FYI, especially as we're getting into these deep shades.
And then last up is Sangria Time. Now, this one in the bullet, I guess it looks, I was expecting it to be just a deep wine shade, but really it ends up looking pretty purpley on me. So this one's not my favorite, just because I don't wear these kind of colors a lot, and it almost has, the glossiness looks kind of bluish. So I think it's fun. I think it's well done and creative, but it's just not one that I'm gonna get a ton of wear out of. But if you like these fun creative colors, I think this one is really done well.
Okay guys, so those are all the different shades of the Wet n Wild Mega Last High Shine lipsticks. So if I had to pick favorites, I would say probably these neutral shades right here, this brownie shade, the two reds, and then these right here, these of the two darker shades. So those are my personal picks, but lots of great fun options in this group. And again, like I mentioned already, I'm so impressed with this formula. It is basically like a lip gloss in a lipstick form. These are so good and super affordable. So I hope that you guys really enjoyed this video and I hope it was helpful for you. Please give it a thumbs up if it was, and let me know down below what you think about these lipsticks, what your favorite shade was that I showed. I love hearing your thoughts and opinions. Ask me any questions that you have. I'm happy to answer those. Please subscribe to my channel if you're not already, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.